grab a cushion or a block and come on your back. Come on your back. You squeeze the cushion between the thighs. I'm going to come a little closer. Like that. Squeezing the cushion between the thighs and the feet off the floor. Now, rest your head on the floor. It's important that you keep your head on the floor so the neck will not be engaged as we engage the core muscles. Otherwise, the neck will be tense and react in one unit with the core. We want to start to be able to isolate the different group muscles. So relax your head down so we can concentrate on the core. The feet up, activate the toes. And interlace fingers like this. Point the fingers towards the ceiling so the shoulder blades can come off the floor, just a little off the floor. Now breathe in slowly. Hold the breath and lengthen the left leg forward. Now exhale and bring the belly muscles down. Now lift your left shoulder a little, but keep the ribs low towards the floor. Exhale fully. Come back to a neutral pose. Breathe in. Hold the breath. Squeeze the block or the cushion. Lengthen the right leg. Shoulder blades off the floor. You breathe out. The belly comes down. And you lift the right shoulder more. Keep squeezing that block. Breathe out. Come back to center to breathe in. We've done that twice. We go to 10. Breathe in. Hold the breath in the lower belly. Lengthen left leg. Bring the belly down towards the floor. Exhale through the nose. Lift the left shoulder more. Squeeze the block. Back to center, breathe in. Hold the breath, squeeze the block, lengthen the right leg, shoulder blades off the floor. The right leg moves up a little, the ribs stay down. Empty the breath. Come back to center, breathe in. Hold the breath. Lengthen left leg, lower your belly, exhale through the nose. Stay here, bring the belly all the way down and lift the left shoulder a bit higher, the left arm. Exhale, come back to center. Breathe in along the ribs. Hold the breath. Squeeze the thighs together, lengthen the right leg. Exhale, and the belly comes down. Take a breath in. Breathe out completely. Take the right shoulder a bit higher, but keep the ribs low. Back to center. That's sixth, four more. Breathe in slowly. Hold the breath, lower abdomen. Squeeze the block, lengthen the left leg. Lower the belly, exhale through the nose. Lift the left arm a bit higher. Keep the ribs low. Breathe out fully. Back to center. Breath in. Squeeze the block. Lengthen the left leg. Bring the belly to the floor. Exhale through the nose. Lift the right shoulder off the floor, but keep the ribs low. Back to center. Breathe in. Hold the breath in the lower belly, squeeze the block, lengthen left leg. Bring your belly down, exhale through the nose. Lift the left shoulder a bit higher. The belly comes down all the way down. Relax to the center, last one, breathe in slowly. Squeeze the block, lengthen the right leg. Lower the belly slowly. Right leg straight. Stay in the pose. Take a breath in between the ribs, the side ribs. Bring the belly all the way down. Lift the right shoulder higher. And relax. Bring the feet down. Remove the block. Open the knees wide. Curl the toes out. Connect the feet into butterfly pose. And wiggle the hips around a few times. Then take a full body stretch. Now the whole hip areas, very low abdominal, are highly energized. Each pose will feel like a walk in the park. Take a few deep breaths. Then bring your knees to your chest and rock from back to front with a synchronized breath. Inhale as you rock back. Exhale as you rock forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale forward, cross the legs. Bring the hands down. Come into a tabletop position. Lower the belly and move the ribs forward. Tailbone goes up, breathe in. Exhale. Pull the belly up, relax the neck down. Inhale into cow. Exhale into cat. Again, a slow breath in to expand forward. Lift tailbone, lower the belly. Press the hands away from the chest. At the same time, rotate arms out. Keep elongating chest forward. Inhale. Then bring the tailbone down. Relax your neck. Pull the belly and the spine up. Exhale. Good. Now take some side stretches. Push the rib cage sideways slowly with a synchronized breath. Exhale as you create opening and space. Breathe into the center. Exhale as you push the ribs to the other side, the rib cage. Do that a few times. And when you're ready for downward facing dog, come into a first down dog. Spread your hands and spread your fingers, your toes. You know what? Come to sit. Before you come to down dog, I want to emphasize something. What, regardless of the posture we choose, some postures have intensity about them. How do we deal with the intensity? The first key is to connect fully with the floor and to engage, not just to be there, but to engage against the floor. And we can only do that if we really spread the contact surface between the body and the floor. So let's do that with the feet and the hands. Bring one ankle on the thigh. And let's spread the foot, interlace the fingers between the toes. Now clasp your fingers on the toes, over the toes, and rotate. Spread the toes, the foot, create some torsion, some rotation, any sort of movement really that gives you a sense of creating space. Am I shouting? Okay. Any kind of movement that gives you a sense of creating space. In both directions, with a slow, synchronized breath. So the way you breathe becomes just a pendant to the way you move. And switch. Spread the toes, spread the foot, and move it in all directions. and come into your Ujjayi breath. Make sure that you can hear the contact of the air in your throat in a way that's not forceful. Breathe through the nose without forcing. Keep it slow, gentle. Now sit up straight. Lengthen your left arm forward with the palm facing forward, the fingers pointing down. Shoulders down, the spine is long. Take a breath in. And as you breathe out, you pull the little finger towards the belly gently. The arm is straight. Breathe out. Inhale. Pull the ring finger. Exhale. Breathe in. Middle finger, exhale. Spread the palm, spread the fingers. Inhale. Exhale, pull the index finger. Breathe in. Now grab the thumb from under and gently pull it towards the shoulder. Breathe out. Shoulders down, arms straight. And do the other hand, arms straight. Breathe in, lift the ribs up. Breathe out, pull the little finger, feel the stretch in the inner arm, in the palm, in the finger. Inhale. Exhale, pull the ring finger, spread the five fingers. Breathe in. Breathe out, pull the middle finger gently, spread the palm. Inhale. Exhale, index finger comes towards the belly. Spread five fingers. Inhale and the thumb. Breathe out. Good. Now shake your wrist a little or close your hands and rotate. Not the arms, just the wrist. Good. Before down dog, let's do a bit more of ribcage opening. It's always a good thing. Fingertips down, open the side, bring the chin down. The forearm maybe comes down, doesn't have to, but if you can do it, to open this side and you breathe out. Activate your fingers, activate your hand. Take a few breaths here. The heart moves forward and up. And you exhale, belly comes in. Now send your arm across the back. Put it just behind your lower back and open this side, lower your hands to the opposite knee. Lift your heart up, keep the chin connected to the chest bone. Bring the belly in and twist, exhale. Inhale to lengthen up, press the sit bones down and grow up, grow taller. Exhale, belly comes in, relax shoulders down. Do three more breaths. Without forcing anything, just notice which part of the spine is twisting. If you do not twist the neck, it will be easier to feel. Breathe in from belly up. And breathe out from chest down. Twist a bit deeper, maybe. Go to the other side, bring this hands down, lower the forearm maybe, open the opposite side, breathe in between the ribs. Relax your neck. Press these hands against the floor. Remember, engagement against the earth. So we can have awareness of where the body is, what position it is in. As you exhale, send your shoulder away from the ear. Spread fingers, inhale. As you exhale, bring the belly in. Relax your face. Expand into the in-breath. Relax into the out-breath. And slowly come up, bring the hands behind the back and come into a gentle twist. Shoulder, this ribcage moves up. On the exhale, you soften shoulders down, soften your face and draw the belly in. Twist. Breathe in, elevate your ribcage up. I guess you cannot elevate down. Belly comes in, exhale. Shoulders down, face is soft. Two more breaths. Maybe to go deeper, or maybe just to feel where you are. And relax. Now is a good time for down dog. Come into down dog with no rush. Keep the legs slightly bent for the first one. Actually, anytime you want. So down dog, spread 10 fingers, spread the toes and push the hips back. Then bring the hips up, keep the legs slightly bent. Bring the right knee under the belly and roll the hips out to the right side. Lower the armpits a little. And as you exhale, push the left heel down. Keep the tailbone up. Come back to the center. Bend the legs, inhale. And bring the left knee under the belly. Lower the right heel down. Hips roll out to the left. Lift the tailbone, press your hands down. Relax the neck. Back to center, breathe in. Send the lower back and the spine as high as you can. Look back, breathe in, open your back. As you exhale, send both heels back down. You can bend the legs slightly. Let's stay here for another three breaths. Straighten both arms, straighten fingers. Roll the shoulder blades out. Not close to the ears, away from the ears. Breathe in. Open your mouth wide and breathe out fully. Again, breath in. And breath out. And one more time, inhale. Exhale to push the hips away from the floor, away from your hands. And bend both legs, look forward, and step to the front of your mat. Come into ragdoll, take the feet apart and fall forward freely. As freely as you can. So it's a falling forward. It cannot be a forceful movement. But notice if there is the opposite of forcing yourself happening. Maybe there is resisting. So bend the legs more, press the toes down, and let your head go down. Feel the shoulders loose. Catch your elbows. Breathe. And swing from side to side. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out through the nose. Breathe abundantly without forcing it. And come out. Let's go to down dog. Feeling the tension. Breathe in through the side. Breathe out, belly comes in. Now bring the left foot in the center and take the right leg up.
empower yourself. Engage against the floor through your hands and lengthen the leg towards the ceiling. Breathe in. Feel that sense of being expansive and in charge. Then step forward, coming to warrior one. Right foot steps forward, the back leg absolutely straight, and to take both arms up.
The front knee above the front ankle. Activate the fingers. Bring the lower ribs in, lengthen up through the rib cage. Exhale, bring the hands down. Bring the knees down, lower the chest as you breathe out.
Then come into cobra, lengthen the legs, lengthen the torso, bring the heart up. Inhale, exhale back to downward facing dog. Take one breath in, spread your hands, press them down. Then take the left leg up, elongate. On the exhale, step forward, left foot forward, warrior one.
Feel your torso elongating upward. Exhale, bring the hands down. Both knees down on the same line, or you come into a plank, it's up to you. Lower the plank, then come into cobra. Stand shoulders back. Press your hands down, tuck the tailbone, breathe in between the ribs, lift your heart, and breathe out, downward facing dog. Straighten both arms, lengthen torso, push the hips back. Relax your neck. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Open your mouth, sigh out. Again, take the right leg up. This time, bend the leg to open the right side of the body. Breathe. Step forward for warrior one. Put your foot down, press the foot down, and send both arms up. Inhale, look up towards the ceiling. Interlace fingers, pull the rib cage higher, then soften shoulders down. Take one more breath in, press the feet down. Open to warrior two. Look forward, flip the front palm. Elongate yourself forward, inhale, and reverse to a peaceful warrior. Exhale. Take one breath in. On the exhale, extended side angle, right hand to the right thigh, and elongate your left side. Relax the neck, look down. Curl the tailbone under, press the feet down, inhale. On the exhale, bring both hands down, come into a plank, maybe with the knees down, lower the plank, exhale. Up dog, inhale, or cobra, and down dog, breathe out, lift the tailbone, press the hands down. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Flutter the lips or sigh out. Lift the left leg up, press both hands down. Bend the leg, lift the knee higher, bend the leg. Breathe and step forward, warrior one, left foot forward. Slowly expanding the chest, the rib cage upwards, then open to warrior two. Both arms straight. Straight spine, not leaning forward too much. Then look forward, lean forward and elongate, inhale, reverse exhale. Left arm forward. Extended side angle, bring the left forearm to the inside of the left thigh. Bring the tailbone down. Lengthen torso forward, high above your thigh. Take your heart high above the thigh, keep the connection elbow to thigh. Then elongate the right arm above the right heel. Relax your face, look down. Curl the tailbone under, breathe, expand more.
Breathe out, bring both hands down. Plank, high plank. Low plank. Coming to Cobra, take your time. Breathe in slowly to feel the breath filling the space within. Downward facing dog, long spine. Bring the heels down. Breathe out. Take three breaths. If you need to come back to child pose for a moment, please do so. Then let's come into dolphin, shall we? Dolphin pose. You can bring the knees down to start. Lower the forearms. We've got two options here. Either you keep the forearms parallel to each other. You don't have to. But by all means, if you cannot keep the forearms parallel to each other, then interlace fingers like this. Or you know what? Let's do it differently. Everybody bring the both forearms parallel and clench your fist, press them down. So it's not flat hand, it's like this with the thumbs up. Yes, thumbs up, dolphin pose. So it's with the hands in this position, you will feel, probably get more awareness of the activation of your wing muscles here. You want to press the upper chest between the armpits, and this arm position should allow you to feel that more. So thumbs up, lift the hips, straighten the legs, breathe, and bring the feet a bit closer to the elbows. Look back, relax the neck, breathe. Stay here for three breaths. Look back, not forward. Look back. Breathe to lift the hips higher. Breathe out, bring the belly in. Inhale to open your back. Exhale to stand the chest a little bit closer to the knees. One more breath. Inhale, open your back. Exhale. And come down slowly, child pose. We will come back to dolphin later on. You will notice that it will feel easier. Send the hips as far back as you can and lengthen torso forward. Then relax shoulders and face and breath. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Feel your breath. Feel your rib cage. Feel all that space between your hips and your neck. Breathe. Breathe more. Then slowly come up. Both feet flat. Spread your weight through both feet. If you need a strap, if you cannot connect your hands in your back, you want to grab something, a t-shirt or a strap or a sock or the cat. No, not the cat. Now grab your prop in one hand, take it up. The other arm, goes around the back, but aware of the shoulder. It's the shoulder that rotates back first. So then the elbow can come all the way in, and then you take the hands up between the shoulder blades. The back of the hand climbing between the shoulder blades. Then you lift this side up, breathe in, and bend your arm towards the back. Connect the hands if you can, or catch the strap. As short as you can. Now keep the cheek against your arm here and lift your elbow, breathe in. Relax the cheeks. Let's take five or six breaths here.
So lift up through the elbow. And as you exhale, relax the opposite shoulder down. Keep the grip short. Breath. Ujjayi breath. Inhale. Two more breaths. Easy breath. Spread the ribcage up. Breathe out, soften shoulder down. Bring the belly in. One more breath. Lift the ribs up. And on the out breath, you let go of the grip. And you deactivate the muscles in the arms. So you let the arms come down. Shake your arms a little. Rotate shoulders. Then switch sides. Take the prop in the other hand. Open up here. Open this arm, rotate shoulder back, bring the elbow in the middle of the back and send the back of the hand between the shoulder blades. If it helps to use the other hand to drive the hand up, yeah, do it. Since the body is not symmetrical, it will not be the same ease on both sides or the same story. And then connect your hands. Breathe in, lift the elbow up. Connect your cheek to your arm. Relax your face. Put a smile on the face, even if it's a fake one. Breathe in from the belly, up. Slow expansion of the body. Slow movement of breath, unresisted. Exhale to relax the shoulder. Inhale to lift the elbow. Three more breaths. And slowly come out. I hope you guys stay in Ujjayi breath. Remember, we don't want to hold the breath and go into panic mode. We want to feed all the space that we're opening with breath energy, attention. Now roll your shoulders a few times and let's come back to dolphin. Before we rush into it, connect with the earth, engage against the floor. That's how you can feel your body lengthening above the floor. If there is nothing to press, just limbo, then awareness of the pose, I don't know where it will be. Connect with the floor. Press the forearms, the palms, the fingers. Take a breath in with a soft face. And breathe out to send the hips high. Keep the shoulders, if you can, above the elbow. Do not send the shoulder forward, the shoulders forward. Take a breath in and look back towards your feet. Keep the neck relaxed. Breathe out, bring the belly in. And start to walk towards your elbows. Now, to keep the shoulders above the elbows, what helps me is to push my chest towards to meet my legs. That keeps the shoulders open, but prevents the shoulders to move and collapse forward. So simply come into your breath. Whatever you feel, press the floor, breathe as softly as you can. Let's hold it for five breaths. Yes, five. So one gone, four to come.
Walk the feet a bit closer and squeeze armpits. Two more breaths. Stay in the pose. Press the hands, forearms down. Lift the hips. Breathe out. Bring the belly in. Slowly. One more breath. Inhale. Press the hands. Squeeze armpits. Send the hips high above the shoulders. Exhale. Bring the belly in. The heels go down. And relax into down dog. Straighten both arms. Come back to down dog. Three breaths in down dog. Take a deep breath in, then flutter the lips or sigh out. Then bring the knees down and come to a seated position. Yeah, that's it. We've done the fiery stuff. Well done, guys. Let's... Oh, what should we do next? I feel, I don't know you, but my hips are so tight in those last few days. I don't know why. My sleep has been funny. My hips are tight. So I think now is a good time for a good hip opener. What do you think? Yeah, I knew you would agree. So let's come into a double pigeon. Sit on the left side. Bring the left shin bone forward. Bring the right foot around. Outside of the knee, point both feet forward. Activate the feet, point the toes forward, then lower this thigh slowly. Yeah. I could come straight in the pose. The reason why I deconstruct that this way is to prevent you guys to go straight like this and damage your knee. So please take the step that you need to make sure that you don't send your knee joint into trauma. Now keep the feet flexed, the toes pointing forward. Bring the fingertips at the back and push yourself slightly forward. Let the flesh of the backside at the back and move the bones a little bit further forward. Lift your heart, inhale, and the ribs. Soften shoulders and face, exhale. Belly comes in. Keep your torso long. The heart is moving up. Relax collarbones and shoulders when you exhale. Keep the feet active. Our pigeon pose is not lotus. You want the heel out of the thigh. Use your Ujjayi breath, long and easy. Now, if you've got your right leg on the top, send both hands out to the left. Flex the right foot here. Connect your fingertips down here. So the sole of the right foot is connected to the right forearm. Does it make sense? Yeah. Both sit bones down. We're not on one cheekbone here. Or butt cheek, cheekbone. No, it's here, butt cheek. Yeah. Fingertips down, lengthen the torso up, inhale. As you exhale, bring the belly in and press the forearm against the sole of the foot to
creates leverage and come into a twist. Soften shoulders down. Inhale, lift your heart. Flex the foot, press it into your forearm. Move the hands a little further forward. And start to lower the chest. Just a little. Maybe the right elbow comes in contact with the sole of the right foot. Breathe in. It's difficult to keep both sit bones down, but let's try for three more breaths. Just stay up here if it's where you need to be. Belly comes in, exhale. And release, bring the top leg down. So both legs are in front of, one in front of the other. Keep the feet pointing forward, send the fingertips forward. Inhale, send the lower ribs forward. Chin up, inhale. As you exhale, bring the belly down. Move the fingers forward. Inhale, traction, rib cage forward. As you exhale, bring the belly down. Inhale, create a bit more length, a bit more space between your ribs. Exhale, soften shoulders and neck, maybe forearms come down. Close your eyes. Breathe through your back. Inhale, send the ribs forward. Exhale, soften down. Belly comes in. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale. So slowly press the hands down, bring the chest up, and switch sides. Sit on the right thigh, shin bone forward. So the foot is not by the groin here, it is forward. The left foot comes around, both feet point forward, and you rotate the left thigh out to bring both sit bones down. Send the toes to point forward. The left heel is not inside, it's out. Now inhale, lift the rib cage up. Exhale, sit on both sit bones and slowly move yourself a little forward. Lift your heart, breathe in. Breathe out. Relax your gaze, relax your jaw, relax your tongue. Relax your intercostal muscles so the breath can be soft again. Come back to your Ujjayi breath. Keep flexing the feet. Lift your heart, inhale. Exhale, slowly through the nose. Send both hands out to the right side. Fingertips down, left forearm connected to the sole of the left foot. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, twist, bring the belly in. Keep the toes active, pointing forward. Curl the toes out. Breathe in, elevate the heart. Breathe out, twist. Breathe out, belly in. Stay here for 5 breaths. Maybe take some little variation, moving the hands into different positions. That's 2 breaths, 3 more, slow, easy breath. And slowly come out. Send both legs forward. Both legs forward, lengthen back of the legs and shake the legs. Roll them in and out. And bring the knees to the chest. Grab the back of the thighs and roll on your back a few times. Then come on your back, feet flat. Lower the knees on one side, release the breath out. And keep the knees down. Keep the shoulder blades relaxed on the mat. Let the legs come down. Especially the top leg here. Refrain from trying to bring it in a certain position, just let it be heavy. How much can you let go? And take a breath in to bring the knees back up, both feet flat. Exhale to lower knees to the opposite side. Release the breath as you move down. Remember, keep your breath in sync with the way you move. You move slowly, you breathe slowly. You breathe slowly, you invite the body to move slowly with awareness. Let go of the hips, the lower back, the lower abdomen, and the thighs. Breathe. Expand between your ribs. And breathe out. Next inhale, bring the knees up. Exhale to the other side one more time. Now bring both knees up close to the chest. Bring your left arm or whatever arm is down on the floor behind both knees here. Yeah, so the knees come up close to the chest. Take a breath in. As you the right shoulder blade can come off the floor. You can come here on the side. Keep the knees up, breathe in. As you exhale, lengthen both legs forward like this. Spread your toes and then bring some little movement around the lower back. Can you roll the hips in that funny position? Little rotations on the hips and lower back. And then go to the other side. Wrap the right forearm behind the knees. Roll to the opposite side. Straighten both legs. I should roll around. Come on the other side. Both legs straight. Knees close to the chest. And you rotate around the lower back. As much as you can. And then bring up, come on your back, grab the knees gently, press the shin bones down, release the breath out. Ah. rock back and forth.
Cross the legs and come into a vinyasa, high plank to low plank to exhale. Pushing through the heels, hold the plank for a moment. Hold the plank, push the chest away from your hands. Relax your face, curl the tailbone down, belly comes up slightly. Breathe, push through the legs, then bring the knees down. If you have to, lower the plank. Lengthen torso forward, send shoulders back, lift your heart, inhale. Lengthen the legs also, press the feet. Cobra and down dog. Spread your 10 fingers, spread the palms of your hands. Take a deep breath in through the nose and a deep breath out, open your mouth. Bend both legs, step forward. Come to a long flat back at the front of your mat. Feet together. Exhale to fold, then slowly come up. Bring the feet together, come into tree pose with your chosen variation into tree pose. Maybe you interlace fingers above your head, or you bring the hands, connect the hands at the back. Or you simply open your hands and straighten your arms with relaxed shoulders, relaxed face. Tree pose. The knee moves out, so the hip opens. Should feel quite open right now. Press against the leg, the foot into the leg. Press the standing foot against the floor. Relax your breath. Stand a bit taller. And come out. Switch side. Breath in first. In your own time. And come out. You know what? Let's do one more round on each side. In your own time, no rush. If you fall out, doesn't matter. Let's try not to fight to find balance. Balance cannot come as a result of fighting. Let's explore what balance is available, how much. How much breath is available. Engage the foot against the standing leg, squeeze the buttock of the standing leg. And release the other side. Oops.
and come out. Feet together, rise up, inhale. Exhale to fall forward. Come to a long flat back, breathe in. Exhale to fold. Come flat on your belly. So we can go to a plank, then come all the way flat. Interlace fingers behind the lower back. Above the lower back. Pull the shoulders back. Straighten both arms to pull the shoulders back. Curl the tailbone down. Breathe in into the lower abdomen. As you breathe out, straighten both legs and lift your heart. Pull shoulders back. Inhale. Relax the face, spread the toes. Try to send the thighs off the floor. And relax. Arms facing up, one cheek down. And again, interlace fingers above the sacrum. Press the palms to pull the shoulders back. Take a breath in, connect low abdomen to the earth and lift your heart, lift your legs. Lengthen torso and legs. Breathe. Relax the jaw. Straighten the legs, activate the toes. One more breath. Inhale. Exhale to expand even more. And release. Roll on your back. And come into any final pose. Happy baby pose, maybe. Or a supine twist. Or a fish. Maybe not a bridge, maybe not anything fiery. Something relaxing. And then Shavasana. Spread your body against the mat. Let the shoulders roll back. Move the shoulder blades down, a bit closer to the hips, away from the neck. Then feel the back of the head in contact with the mat. Relax your ears, your scalp, your forehead. Relax the whole face, your arms, your hands. Fingers. Notice the sensations in your fingers and palms. The sensation of the back of the hand resting on the floor. Can you feel the weight of your arms and hands? And stop carrying them. Feel your spine pressing it gently into the rubber of your mats. The back ribs. How much of the ribs can you feel pressing gently against the mat at the back of the rib cage? Notice as you breathe, the breath is pressing your ribs down and lifting your chest bone up. Relaxed breath. But powerful. Feel the expansion of the belly. And relax the sacrum down. Allow it to come flat, to connect with the floor. Let go of the hip joints, any tension around the hip joints. Allow that to dissolve. And relax the legs, the back of the knees, the calves and the ankles and the feet, all the way to the tip of the toes. Let go of the ujjayi breath. Allow the natural rhythm of your breath to come back, to reset itself. Naturally, it will. But keep feeling the breath as a slow and gentle wave coming in and out, washing over the whole body. Start to deepen your breath. Bring some little movements in toes and fingers. Stretch on one side. Stretch to the other side. Then bring the knees close to the chest. Stretch your back, lower back, and roll on one side. To rest on one side with the neck relaxed and come up slowly to sit up tall, spacious, straight. Connect your hands by your heart. Relax shoulders down, lengthen the spine up, take a breath in and take a full breath out. Let's bow forward to acknowledge ourselves and each and every one of us here present.